A quick thank you to the T5 peeps. Bob the Dragon, Data Magnet, Cat Crab Lobster, Duck Machine, Try Again 95, Astray the Dreamer, Mezik, Budic Joel, German Chemist, Casper Arnholtz, and Chaos to Must. Thank you very much. A warning, written by Kaiser5243. You sit before me in this dark place and ask, "You who hunt the humans, what are their weakness?" And I laugh, because they have none. You come to me now in this night, not to avoid their notice, but because my kind, those who prey upon them, fear the light. You prostrate yourself before us and beg, "How do we defeat them?" Yet the only answer I can give you is, you cannot. You demand of a dark a way to subjugate those who you see as weak, but those of us in the night just grin our fanged grin and offer you the challenge to try. I am old, older than you can possibly imagine. I was there for the birth of Sumeria and the fall of Rome. I watched the great British Empire with their steam factories colonize the world. I stood silent while the two great powers pointed their nuclear armaments at each other and did nothing, and would you like to know why? Because you cannot beat them. My kind are faster and stronger than they could ever hope to be. We do not age, we do not die. All we need to do is drink their blood, and eternal life is ours to behold. Yet we hide. Do you know why? Do you know why the lupine take to their fields in the full moon? Why they avoid the dense civilizations they could easily overpower in a single evening? Do you understand why the fae courts stay in their forests? Why they don't tempt the whole of humanity with their decadent parties and irresistible foods? You can't possibly fathom why me and mine don't roll them under our iron fist like we do our own. No. Or if you did, you would not sit here before me. Humanity does not lose. We may take a few here and there. We may even convert a few to our kind. But should they discover us, should they break the masquerade, they would hunt us with such a fury your superior intellects could not comprehend. We do not hide in the shadows because we are weak. No, we hide because they are strong. Can you imagine the things you warn your children about, the monsters in the dark hiding from you? They tell tale after tale, movie after movie, book after book, warning of how dangerous we can be, and yet we hide. We don't dare let them see our faces. We don't dare let them know we actually walk amongst them. You sit before me and ask for my insight, for my advice. Run. We don't like you. You come here thinking you can conquer our world. You think you can move in on our hunting ground. This is your one warning. Their stories have a truth to them. Every single one. And what stories they weave. Stories of them defeating evils, vanquishing demons in the night. Knights in shining armor defeating horrors that you can't possibly imagine. So I'll tell you now, run while you still can. For we are those horrors in the night. We are the things they scare their children with while telling tales of our defeat. We are the ghouls in the dark that fill their movies and books that they defeat over and over again. And we fear them. We fear them because their stories are true. They do kill us again and again. They will fight to the last and fight with a ferocity no creature on your planet will ever match. We fear them because we used to be them. Our forms, twisted and tainted, made stronger than they could ever hope to be, but still separated from them. And there lies our weakness. So run. Run back to those far stars from which you came and never return. And should others ask you if they should hunt here, tell them humanity's nightmares will defend them. God help you if you fight what hides under our beds. End of story. Story number 2. The Extinction of the Dragon Cats, written by SlowAD2584. What's this? Planning an attack on a human mining colony? Sit down, boy. Let me tell you why that's the stupidest thing that you could ever think of. Let me tell you a story, boy. About not judging a book by its cover. About not crossing certain lines. And also why you never ever make humanity think of you as any sort of enemy or threat. It has to do with the Xyrak, its so-called dragon cat species. Humans said that they looked like a mix between a tiger and a Nile crocodile. All the speed and all the armor. Yeah, you've never heard of them. They are long gone, wiped off the face of the galaxy. Oh, there may be a few here and there, but they are huddled in the shadows now, terrified of ever being seen. It's kind of sad, actually. The dragon cats were apex predators that attained galactic alliance status millennia ago. Their culture was about the pride of the hunt, and the majority of their technological and cultural factors were closely linked to this hunt. They were excellent mercenaries, soldiers for hire without peer. They were just too fast, their senses too sharp, their claws and jaws too mighty, and the hide was too tough. What happened to them? Well, it's hard to pin down, and no one can seem to prove anything. But it's pretty clear what happened. The dragon cats claimed the newly joined humans of Earth as a weak and pathetic prey species, worthy of only food. They saw the humans had no natural weaponry. Even their teeth were dull. No armor, sluggish movements, and pathetic senses. They deemed the humans to be helpless water bags stumbling about. The humans tried to file a complaint that this was a breach against the Galactic Charter, and that they wished the dragon cats to be sanctioned and properly contained. But then the raid happened. There is a line in the sand, a term the humans use, that should never be crossed. This line is different for each species, but it is important to have it established into a species charter with the Alliance. The humans had a pretty sensible line that they would never cross. Nuclear bombs, chemical and biological agents, the standard fare. But apparently, there was another line, and crossing it was unthinkable. It was still not entirely clear what exactly was the line that they crossed, but, well, let me tell you a story. The dragon cats raided a small town on Earth. It was a slaughter. Every man, woman, and child was killed. And in the very public way, the dragon cats were arrogant and wanted their kills to be open on display, so linked their own senses to the Earth internet. As they were piling the bodies into their shuttle transports, several dogs were growling and standing over the dead humans' bodies. The dragon cats set the village on fire and picked up the dogs and publicly ate them alive. Right there on the spot. May determined they actually liked the taste of dog and found a puppy daycare building full of puppies. And had a joyful feast on a full broadcast display to the internet before flying away, picking their teeth. They made it clear that this was the new normal, that hunts would continue. It was just their way. Like I said, we still aren't sure what terrible line was crossed there. Was it the woman being killed, the children, the town being burned? We don't know. And the humans aren't talking about it. Things were quiet for a time. Then it started happening. Dragon cat heads just started to explode. Everywhere. On streets, in center councils, on transports. It was weird. No one could explain why or how the mess was just too complete. Dragon cat ships also began suffering odd mechanical failures. Literally, spontaneously exploding. Or falling out of orbit en masse. While humans were indeed nearby in every situation, none of the apparent murders or sabotages could ever be linked to them. And they were all coldly silent when interviewed. Yet dragon cats were dying galaxy-wide by the millions. Then it got worse. Massive comets were spotted arcing in from Dragoncat's homeworld or cloud. All were oddly lined up to impact the homeworld. And also, all were timed to strike simultaneously. The Dragoncats had a mighty space fleet and were able to intercept all of the cometary bodies before impact. But in hindsight, this was only a trick to get all of their fleet into one place. And that's when the hack occurred. And all the Dragoncat warships started glitching and opening fire on all surrounding ships, tearing the entirety of the fleet to scrap. Again, the battle site assessment found no evidence of any human involvement. This software just seemed to have had a design flaw inherent in it, apparently. It would have taken a very clever and devious mind to have found some way to exploit it and leave absolutely no trace behind. By this point, the Dragoncats were starting to see writing on the wall as their economy began to collapse due to unknown whales disrupting their stock market with massive buyouts and dumps. The Dragoncats started to rage publicly. "Cowards! Face us and fight like a true war!" They cost their head exploded right there at the podium. And his ship broke and its crew mysteriously died right there at the docking bay. After that, other species of the Galactic Alliance started to quietly distance themselves from the Dragoncats. Clearly, something terrible was going on, and they wanted no part of it. In the end, the Dragoncats were desperate as they noticed the star in their home system started fluctuating. "Please, members of the Alliance, whoever is doing this, we will surrender and sign any demands before you..." Splat. There was a hint by this point that the headshots were actually shots from a high-powered projectile weapon of some kind. But no gunman, gun, or even bullet was ever found. What kind of soldier fights this way? How patient and precise and coldly efficient must he be to remain undiscovered even now with the whole galaxy trying to figure it out? And yet still execute high officials so very publicly. Almost as if the publicity was part of the point of something. The star of the Dragoncat system went over. No one really knows why or how. Within 6 months of the raid on Earth, the Dragoncats were no more. A bullet made of hypercrystalline ice was found on the Dragoncat Council seat one day. Was it a warning, a statement, a hint? What the heck is an ice bullet good for anyway? It would just melt. So that's the story, boy. I know when you look at humanity, you don't see much. Soft, puffy skin covering exposed, unprotected organs. Slow, clumsy hands and watery eyes stumbling around as if in the dark most of the time. But we all know, or at least suspect, in the secret meetings that we agree that there is an unknown darkness in the human's mind. A terrible world that, if properly motivated, unchains a horrible aspect of human nature. Well, they play nice as a whole. Apparently, there are some lines with them that you do not cross. Humanity's cleverness and wit can take a terrible turn if things come to it. The cold, silent, utter removal of the Dragoncat species without a word ever spoken can attest to that. We all dearly wish to know where exactly that line was to ensure that we never cross it by mistake. And on that note, boy, take those plans and raid a human mining colony and shred them. And never even think that again. Do you want to risk crossing that line? End of story. And that, my friends, concludes this video.